Good evening. Melbourne has hit another COVID high, this time 1,965 new cases and projections. We're on track to reach 3,000 daily infections. But there is some good news. Isolation rules are easing and the push to vaccinate is bringing freedoms closer. The state is now due to hit 70% fully vaccinated 2 weeks from today.
Spring sunshine in Melbourne, but another daily case record, 1,965. Now more than 17,000 active cases. One of them, 26-year-old Georgia Milsom, forced to live in a tent in her family's backyard because she does not want to infect them.
My stepdad, he couldn't afford to not work. My family needs to pay their bills. I've got a five-year-old brother.
She's pleaded with authorities, but there's no room in hotel quarantine for her. She'd been living in her car until her mum bought the tent.
It's hard. It is really hard not having access to basic human things.
COVID now so overwhelming, authorities have given up trying to track secondary close contacts. They will no longer have to isolate.
A text message will be sent to our 16,000 secondary close contacts this weekend to advise them of this change and to release them from quarantine.
So now only those who've had direct contact with the COVID positive will isolate. Their household members or workmates no longer considered secondary close contacts. They should avoid the primary contact, but
those people can go to work, can go to Coles or Woolworths and get the shopping done, walk the dog, whatever it might be, they can go about their normal day-to-day life.
We're on track for 3,000 daily cases by the end of October, as predicted by modelling. Tragically, 5 people died with COVID. 578 people are in hospital, 117 in ICU, 83 on ventilators.
Those patients stay in intensive care a lot longer than other patients with other conditions. So we're looking at the strain only going up in intensive cares over the next few weeks and months.
The federal government is fast-tracking visas and travel for 2,000 British and Irish nurses to ease the strain Australia-wide.
We would be interested in any opportunity that gets, staff from anywhere that have got significant ICU experience.
The state government denies its poor planning. They've always recruited overseas nurses.
It's happening prior to the pandemic. It's happening during the pandemic, and I would expect that it will continue to occur post-pandemic.
We're running ahead of the vaccination schedule, so we could get roadmap easing early.
It's in all our power to bring those dates forward, and we'd love to see them as soon as we possibly can.
But for Georgia Milsom, the COVID struggle is relentless now.
It's been 2 years into this virus, and, I would have thought that there'd be something more set in stone for our growing case numbers in the community.
Nick McCallum is at the airport tonight. Nick, Virgin Airlines has been hit by a major COVID scare.
Mike, a Virgin flight crew member has tested positive after flying on 6 separate flights over 3 days this week. So now authorities are trying to contact all passengers from these flights, to and from Adelaide on October the 4th, to and from Sydney on October the 5th, and to and from Newcastle on October the 6th. Now, the COVID surge is so great in Melbourne, Virgin is now requiring all its employees here to have a COVID test by Monday. And that includes ground staff and back office workers, Mike.
Nick McCallum live at the airport.